I think so many technology companies are trying to solve problems of people who live in like a few specific cities of this particular country, mm-hmm. when in reality, building the future that we want or that we'd be proud to hand to our kids involves humanity solving problems at global scale.
Right.
This is Zipline Drone Delivery. The startup, founded in 2014, helped build hype for a future filled with packages falling conveniently from the sky. As that future becomes more of a reality, Zipline will have to compete with the likes of Amazon's Prime Air.
Let me show you something.
Oh my God!
Remember when Jeff Bezos unveiled an octocopter on 60 Minutes?
These are octocopters.
That was a decade ago. No octocopters yet, but Amazon is making slow progress. And Alphabet's Wing is getting off the ground as well.
Hello!
Hey, thank you for coming.
Good to see you. No, yeah. It's good to see you again. It's been a while.
Welcome to Zipline. We serve 8 countries. Today we serve about 3,500 hospitals and health facilities globally. It's become the largest commercial autonomous system on Earth.
Zipline honed its technology first in Rwanda, delivering blood, vaccines, and other medical supplies, especially to rural areas that were previously poorly served by land.
Does that like give you chills that you guys are out there saving lives?
It definitely never gets old, especially when we get to go spend time with doctors, meet patients who are benefiting from the system, and it's been really cool to see the system scale.
Can you show us how the magic happens?
Yeah, let's do it. So this is Zipline's main manufacturing area. Zipline has 2 products today. Platform 1 is really focused on enterprise delivery. Mm-hmm. Platform 2, we're launching with customers in a few months.
So that's the one that's going to be delivering all the packages to my door.
Yep, exactly. We're a pretty full stack company. Huh? We're building LRUs, or line replaceable units, mm-hmm. so basically the sub-assemblies of the aircraft.
It all happens here.
Yeah. You can think of this as like the ears of the aircraft. So we're passing a huge amount of air through here. Okay. It's like a really quiet wind tunnel. Yeah. This is the paraland tube. If we're encountering such insane weather conditions or there's like systematic failure throughout the entire aircraft and across multiple levels of redundancy, then we can deploy the parachute so we can bring the aircraft gently to the ground. This is the reason that through 50 million commercial autonomous miles, Zipline has had 0 human safety incidents. See these 2 holes?
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna line those up with those 2.
I think I can do that.
Nice, you did it. Good job.
Oh. Not heavy at all.
Yeah, or you're really strong. This is the advantage of carbon fiber materials. You can design something that's really strong. It's designed to go up to about 3 Gs of load. Where we are now, we call it Nest Zero. This is actually the first test site.
What's the grand plan?
When we started building Zipline, the more we thought about logistics, the more we realized global logistics really only does a good job of serving people in the golden billion. So, you know, the richest billion people on Earth, your access is probably okay. Mm-hmm. But for the 7 billion people who don't fall into that category, your access either sucks or is non-existent. Mm-hmm. And as a result of that, 5.5 million kids under the age of 5 lose their lives every year due to lack of access to basic medical products. From a mission perspective, what's exciting to us about building an automated logistics system is that will be the first logistics system that serves all people equally. Mm. It will enable us to transition logistics to zero emission. It'll also enable universal access to a lot of different products, including life-saving products.
So not to overly simplify it, but is it the goal to be like a modern day UPS or FedEx, or is this something bigger?
I actually think the opportunity to build a system that is 10 times faster, half the cost, zero emission, and broadly available to every human on Earth is probably like 10 times or larger. Emily, this is Fabiola.
Hi.
I started at Zipline 4 years and a few months.
And it was Rwanda 1?
Yes.
It's basically members of the Rwanda and Ghana flight operations teams now having to train all of our US team members on how to do this at scale.
Any bottles?
All right. That's amazing.
Ton of t-shirts.
Oh, t-shirts, guys.
and water.
So prepared. So is the goal to deliver everything from blood to vaccines to my Kleenex and sushi?
I mean, it turns out that our customers want everything. In the US, a good analogy, you know, with Walmart, we had initially planned to launch with them around their pharmacy business. Mm-hmm. They're one of the largest pharmacies in the US. We launched delivering healthcare products, but very rapidly it was clear that customers wanted to order everything. And so today we deliver like 24,000 of the 29,000 SKUs in the store that we're attached to.
You do have competition, Amazon Prime Air, Alphabet's Wing. What makes you think you can lead this market?
I think there are a lot of big companies with kind of infinite resources talking about this market, but you know, talk and walk are different things. Mm-hmm. We are the largest commercial autonomous system on Earth, mm-hmm. of any kind, ground or air. Mm-hmm. So
compared to Amazon?
You know, a lot less. you'll have to ask them that question.
Zipline's first delivery drones were all about getting supplies to places with enough space to drop packages from midair to the ground. The company's platform, too, is all about precision and reaching more dense urban areas.
One of the most important things about making the overall system work is how do we integrate with all the different companies that want to take advantage of this to essentially enable teleportation from their businesses or warehouses or stores directly to a home. Zipline can basically show up and install a magical portal in your wall. That's kind of how we talk about it.
It's a Harry Potter door.
Yeah, right? I think it was like Rick and Morty door, but you can basically choose what you want to load.
Okay.
So. Do you have any preferences?
I mean, pizza and coffee.
Pizza and coffee? Okay.
Everyone has to have pizza and coffee, right?
So I'll put the pizza in here and you can do the coffee.
Okay. I mean, is this gonna spill in there?
Okay.
All right. There you go.
So you just teleported something via zipline. That's it.
Pretty cool.
We need to be able to deliver silently with dinner plate level accuracy. This is the only thing that's coming close to you, your family, your house. It's really cute. It's not making very much noise. It's totally safe.
What's going to happen to the UPS guy? I mean, what about jobs?
Any new technology, there's always this worry that it's going to like put people out of jobs. So I think the reality is like we're in a world where unemployment is, you know, the lowest basically it has been over the last 30 mm-hmm. years. Generally, I think there are not enough humans to do the work and labor that we want done to live like abundant, mm-hmm. rich lives.